second, would you? Catch my breath. I'm a little out of shape, I can admit. But also, believe it or not, that's the first time I've ever had to drag a body. He's as heavy as you might expect. Okay. Funny thing is, I think most of his weight is right there in his stomach. How does that song go? The night before Christmas, he's got a bowl full of jelly, right? It's more like a dump truck full of bricks. His arms and his legs, fairly average. I'm assuming he works out, but I don't think he does any sit-ups. I don't know. I can't imagine what his diet consists of. Oh, and don't worry. He's not dead. He's just heavily sedated, as we planned. Oh, and by the way, thank you very much for your special delivery. Intentions, but Christmas still came for all the Whos in Whoville, right? And you know why? It's not because of love or joy or that the Whos didn't need decorations and Christmas trees. It's not because of the ham and all that. It's for one reason that Christmas still came for the Whos in Whoville. And you're looking at them right over there in the corner. This is what the Grinch should have done. You can take all the Christmas trees and decorations and Christmas ham away, but if you don't take out that guy from the equation, well, of course, Christmas is still gonna come. Duh. So, I know the Grinch, you know, he had, like I said, he had the somewhat good idea, but he is a bit of an amateur. I mean, let's admit it, right? Not too smart. So, yeah. And then, yeah, like I said, don't worry. He's out cold. I checked his pulse. He's just fine. And, okay, well, I guess we should get to it. I hope you are nice and comfortable. Kind of excited to see what Santa has in his sack. Speaking of which, Santa's sack was this big. Okay. So many goodies in here. Alright, I think what I'm gonna do is just move this to the side where I had it. Obviously, he's not gonna have think that he slipped and fell on his way to the Christmas tree. You know, he won't suspect a thing. That's the great part about this plan. So, his sleigh and his reindeer, they're still outside. We don't have the time to unload his sleigh. We only have about, an hour and a half, something like that, to go through the presents in his sack to get him back near the Christmas tree. Maybe next year we can, get everything from his sleigh as well. But this was our first attempt. And, we got lucky. It worked out. All right, so you're nice and comfortable. All right, good. And I hope you've been well since the last time you and I got a chance to see each other and hang out. All right, hopefully you're doing splendastic or better. I think by the time we're through here, you'll be beyond splendastic. Alright, okay, I'm gonna stop yapping, and let's go through the presents in Santa's sack. Alright? Okay, there was one present he had in his hands before he fell over unconscious. This one. It says, I don't know why he didn't use any little holiday Christmas themed labels. He just kind of used a Sharpie and wrote directly on the Christmas wrapping. But maybe was in a hurry. I don't know. But it says, to ephemeral rift from Santa. So. We'll save that one for last, okay? Alright. Let's see. There's one of the first presents that fell out of his sack. Nice little bow. This one says, to person who likes nice noises, from Mr. C. Let's open this up. Jealous already. I don't know who that particular person was who likes nice noises that was supposed to get this, but I know this is not the most moral and ethical thing to do, to steal other people's presents, but it's not. There's only about 20 here. in my universe. Not the same as Santa in your universe. Which is why, I'm sure this is why it took you a little bit longer to get here. You had to travel through some rifts. But, so, yeah. As you know, we live in an omniverse, infinite universes. So this is just one Santa of the infinite number of Santas that exist. So these 20 presents that aren't going to get delivered, it's just like a grain of sand on a beach. Okay, so don't feel too bad. I'm sure Santa, when he goes through his sack and, you know, I'm sure he has a backup plan for when presents go missing. I mean, I'm sure as he's riding in his sleigh through the stratosphere at high speeds, a few presents are bound to fall out of the sack or off the back of his sleigh. So I'm sure he has some, backup plan. All right, so. But, anyway, yeah. Bubble wrap. I wonder if the person that was supposed to get this likes this because of this sound. What I'll do, since I'm not completely evil, I'll rewrap the presents the best that I can, put them back into the sack, at least the ones maybe we're not going to keep, and then Santa won't be any the wiser. I don't know, but anyway. this one. Four bows on it. Must be very special. Let's see. This one says, to everyone who thinks I'm not real, from Santa. How do you deliver a present to everyone? Unless, wait a minute, do you think Santa could have known about this whole scenario? I mean, he does know when you're naughty and nice. He's got his little elves working for him. He's like omnipotent or omniscient or whatever. I don't know. Maybe he knew all about this, what's going to happen to him tonight. Anyway, I want to find out what's inside this one. Wow. Santa with a big middle finger to all the non-believers. Let's see. This next one says, to Sally from Santa. must be 5 or 6. I kind of feel bad stealing from a kid. Just a little bit bad about it. Let's see. Let's open this up. Spend too long on each present. He could wake up sooner than expected. Let's just check out some of the flashcards. Let's see. Amazing how just as a quick glance, a simple little picture, one letter, and you can immediately think of, you know, what it is. It's pretty interesting how the brain works. O for octopus. B for bear. Santa's sack. I mean, it's for a 5 or 6 year old girl named Sally. So, yeah, I don't want to take a little kid's present. Well, it's not so much that, but I don't really want flashcards anyway. Okay, moving on. one says, to Dave from Santa. I mean, there's a lot of Daves, but only Santa knows which particular Dave is getting this. So obviously, he doesn't need to put the last name. And they're like vintage 70s or 80s ties, maybe 90s, but 70s or 80s, I think. Says designer collection. I'm not gonna keep these. We'll put this back in Santa's sack. We're only gonna keep, you know, the good presents. I'm sure there's some gold jewelry, diamond jewelry, some really good stuff that's worth keeping. This is Land's End. next present. Let's find out what's inside. Pencils, of course, although if I was a teacher, I'm not sure I would want something for Christmas that reminds me of work. But, and they're Dixon, wow, top of the line pencils, 8 Dixon pencils. Gonna keep this. Do you know how much these you know what? We might keep all these presents, including little 5-year-old Sally's flashcards, because I forgot that all these presents and the whole purpose of us doing this is because they'll fetch high price on the black markets in all the different universes that exist. So while number 2 pencils in this universe aren't worth anything, I know of a universe where a particular organism eats pencils. So they'll catch a high price in that universe, Dixon Ticonderoga pencils. Easy way to do this. has the greatest the pencils. Alright. On to the next present, my friend. This one says, two ephemeral rifts, viewers, from Santa. That's interesting. Again, that makes me kind of think that Santa knew that all this was going to take place. I guess there's no, you know, getting one past Santa. So, he's kind of like God, in a way. Let's just open it up and find out what's inside. Sketch. Have you ever had one of these, played with one of these? I remember having one way back 70s or 80s when I was a kid. I was never, could never really master it, but it was always fun. Say to my viewers. So I'm not sure what he means. Oh, got a little card here or a note. It says, "Dear Mr. E.R. Paul, would you please make a video with this? Your biggest fan, Santa. P.S. I love Pauline." And then there's a little arrow to read the next. "Don't tell Mrs. Claus." I guess Santa maybe falls asleep to a Pauline video. Anyway, so that's what Santa meant by to my viewers, I guess he kind of a request. Would you like to? I mean, I think I'm gonna do it anyway. I'll do a video unboxing this, tapping on it, and then trying to make some stuff with the Etch-a-Sketch. Hopefully it makes some nice sounds. Sketch. So, well, thanks, Santa. This whole plan, I kind of have somewhat of an evil intent, obviously, but now I'm starting to feel a little guilty. Maybe we shouldn't have knocked out Santa and just kind of invited him to with us. But, you know, this is more fun. Okay, etch a sketch. Alright, we'll do that in a video. On to the next present. Okay. I'm pretty sure this fetches a high price in some universe. On to the next present. Another to my viewers from Santa. Honeycomb ball. Oh, I think when you open it and close it, it makes some nice scrunchy sounds. Maybe that's why Santa got this for us. Up. Okay, I remember having one of these before at some point in my life. Sound you like? Thank you. is going to be something to add to my ASMR repertoire, so to speak, and probably make some appearances, become a staple in some videos. Seems to make a nice sound. I like it. Hopefully you do too. Okay. Next present. Looks like a box. It says, "Do nothing shop, owner, number 834972. I didn't know there were that many nothing shops. I thought there was just one. But, well, this is an omniverse, infinite universes. Could be infinite nothing shops. Or could be 8,300 or 834,972 of them. Although, I doubt that's the last one. There could be 5 billion of them. Anyway. Wonder what's inside. Wonder what's inside. Sounds like nothing is inside. Could it be? Sure is. is nothing. Amazing. Just look at the quality. I'm sure that will fetch a high price somewhere in another universe. Definitely keeping that. Okay. Thanks, Santa. On to the next present. Squishy. Let's open it up. Let's open it up, see what it sounds like. I don't have any water readily available. I would dunk this into the water, make some great squishy sounds, but, well, I hate to take this away from as a name, like Sponge Bill or Sponge Mary or Sponge. I'm trying to think of if there's any type of fictional cartoon character that has a name starting with Sponge. I don't think so. No. Okay. Next present. This one says to Marcus. It's opening up. It's a little bit noisy. I guess little Marcus was looking forward to being a fireman when he grows up. But I hate to take a little toy from a kid, but this could fetch a high price on the black market in some universe, so. And I'm sure Marcus will be just fine, you know, getting something else. Much a good idea for Marcus to grow up to be a fireman. I mean, it's a volunteer job. You risk your life. I'm not sure if it pays well, but maybe this is a good idea. Marcus doesn't get this. We can just dash his dreams of becoming a fireman on the rocks. And he'll grow up to choose another profession that won't risk his life. So, anyway. On for now. On to the next present. This one says to the greatest table in the Omniverse. What's with these supposedly inanimate objects getting presents for Christmas? unless they're not inanimate. So, from big S is what it says. Open. I'm not sure how much longer Santa is going to be knocked out, but we've been here for longer than an hour, and gotta move through these presents a little more quickly. Anyway, to the greatest table in the omniverse. A plastic table skirt. Oh, now it makes sense. So, it's like a skirt for a woman, but for a table, it's a plastic. Table skirt. So I don't know if that means it's a skirt for a plastic table or it's a plastic skirt. Looks like a plastic skirt. Could be a plastic skirt for a plastic table. I kind of feel bad taking this away from that table, but I'm sure this will fetch a high price somewhere in the omniverse. Take this out real quick, see if it makes any pleasant sounds. Oh yeah. I might not sell this on the black market, but keep it for myself to use in some videos. In some videos, along with that paper globe thing. one says to Billy from Santa, of course. Let's get this open. This one says to the neurodivergent community, love Santa. So I have no idea what this could be. See that? Dinosaurs. not sure. Raptor. Velociraptor. Crazy long claws. Brontosaurus. Right? It's been decades, like 40 years, since I've done anything related to dinosaurs. Or was taught anything. I think that's a brontosaurus. Stegosaurus, right? I think so. No, Stegosaurus is... No, this might be... Yeah, I think this is a Stegosaurus. I feel like that's wrong. I feel like I want to Triceratops. Triceratops, right? Because of the three horns. Stegosaurus, right? I think. With the pointy tail. Let's see. There's also a game. We'll get to that in a second. Or something. I don't know the name of this one. I know I've heard the name before, but... This one I have no idea the name of. It looks like a malformed T-Rex with a lumpy head. Says made in China. What's the name of it? Does it give a name? Doesn't have a name. Okay, that sucks. Don't know the name of that one. And then this one says made in China as well. It doesn't have the name anywhere. Okay. So there we go, Santa's present for the neurodivergent community, dinosaurs. And now for the classic battle between T-Rex and Stegosaurus, right? Stegosaurus. Yeah, I think that's, no, not Stegosaurus, Triceratops. Triceratops gets a T-Rex in the stomach with the horns. T-Rex doesn't like that, tries to bite. Bite Triceratops in the face, maybe bite his back. Triceratops with the horns. And they both kind of part ways because it's just not gonna, neither one's gonna win, so. Do you have a favorite dinosaur? I think I like them all. And a dinosaur game. Oh, this is one of these classic games where you have to get the little rings onto the poles or whatever. as fun as video games these days, but yeah, okay. Well, the neurodivergent community is definitely not getting any of these dinosaurs. These fetch high price somewhere in the omniverse. Next present. This one says to Susie. It's a different kind of tissue package of the Elder Gods. Just look at the Eldritch writing on it. And take this hat off. Sally, she won't be getting this. So now there are two known tissue package of the Elder Gods in existence, or two that we know of. Myself, not gonna sell it. Okay, on to the next present. This one says to Margaret. I wonder if it's the same Margaret. Santa and Margaret. I don't know. Maybe Santa has a thing for Margaret too. I mean, if it's the same Margaret, but I don't know. And it's kind of interesting that you can buy real official police handcuffs, or at least they make them like this. I mean, you know, it says for ages 4 and up. So, police handcuffs, wow. I never would have thought that. I would only think that police officers were the only ones that could, you know, have access to these, but okay. Next present. This one says to Benjamin from Santa. Benjamin. I feel like I've heard that name before. Benjamin. Set. Wow. It has a little hammer for your reflexes. It's got the stethoscope, a medicine box, a bandage box, a thermometer, the little thing to look in your ears, maybe nose, a little mirror to look in your mouth, I think, and some scissors for cutting the bandages. Benjamin. Could it be the same Benjamin at Arkham Sanitarium? You know what? I really like that kid guy, old man, with the clone of the professor with the body of an 8-year-old, or mind of an 8-year-old. Maybe I'll put this back in. Yeah, I'm gonna put this back in Santa's sack so Benjamin can get it. And who knows, maybe we'll see Benjamin, you know, play doctor. Yeah, okay. All right. Yeah, that will go back in the sack. Next present. This one says, to the greatest Sudoku puzzle solver ever. Wow, okay. Sudoku puzzle solver ever. Easygoing crosswords. Large print. Huh. Why would Santa give a Sudoku, the greatest Sudoku puzzle solver ever, crosswords? Maybe Santa got the presents mixed up. I mean, he is old. So, let's see what one down would be. Ice cream treat S. One down. Okay, there's... I really need a pen. Okay. Alright. Well. I think I'll use this in a video. Maybe we'll try to solve some crosswords. Okay, I'll keep that. Just a few presents left. This one says, to your dad. See what it is. A kitchen apron. A very nice floral design. So, I'm not sure if this was for your dad, for my dad, or for whoever was supposed to get this, but for their dad. So I don't know. Let's open this up, see what it sounds like. Some nice, soft, crinkly sounds. Sitting down. But, okay. Well, this is for your dad. So maybe you should take this, okay? Here you go. At least I'm assuming it's for your dad. Okay, next present. This one says, to Pauline from Santa. So, that's for me. Well, for my feminine side, that is. I'm not sure if you've met Pauline, but anyway, let's see what this is. Like a purse, or, well, not nice big. Yeah, I guess Pauline would like this. So, thanks, Santa. On behalf of Pauline, of course. It's like a faux snake skin design. Maybe. I think we might see Pauline again early 2024, so maybe she'll do some kind of what's in my bag or pursey thing. So I won't. This one says two, number 503-481902. I have no idea who or what that might be or what that number even means. Sex, waterproof, lightweight, durable PEVA, one size fits all, for hiking, amusement parks, outdoor festivals. Let's open this up. I think I'll keep this and use it and put it on in another video. references to the greatest poker player ever. American Heritage Dictionary. I have no idea why a poker player would need this. Again, maybe it's another example of Santa going senile and messing up. Maybe a person who loves dictionaries is getting the poker player's gift. Let's see, this was printed. This was published in 1983. Oh, it has that classic old book smell. Here, take a whiff. Oh, you want some more? Sure. Something, I don't know what to do with it, but maybe we'll sell it. Maybe Deep One Dave could use it in his thrift shop. I don't know. Wait a minute, Deep One Dave. Maybe that's who those ties were for. Okay, last present. It's a biggie. To the professor. Pretty heavy. A few pounds. Let's see what this is. Shoes, obviously. Size 11.5. I guess we know the professor's shoe size now. I'm at 10.5. So. I don't know if I want to. to mess around with the professor's gift. Who knows what he could end up doing to me if he finds out. I might put these back in Santa's sack. Okay, my friend, well, I think it's time to wrap things up. Get it? Wrap things up. Santa might be waking up any moment now, and I think it's best that we clean up and put some of these gifts back in his sack, move him back near the Christmas tree and everything. So again, thank you for your help, and it was great to have you join me in this, my cohort, my accomplice, but I hope that you're nice and relaxed now, maybe falling asleep. It's hard for me to tell in this light, but that's gonna do it. So if you want to just, I'll take care of everything here, I'll take care of Santa, you just, maybe you're trying to fall asleep, you just drift off, and I'll take it from here, okay? And I hope to see you again in the new year. Happy holidays if you celebrate. If you don't, then happy regular day. And I wish you all my best. And hopefully we'll see each other in the new year, okay? Until then, I'm just gonna do a little bit of this. First present. To me, from Santa. Gotta open this up. Sea, but all the same.